Morning students, now we'll be doing exercise 4.5. Exercise 4.5 of NCERT. What else do I do? I always solve the problems of NCERT only. So it's obvious, but customarily I'm writing it again. NCERT, class 6. Exercise 4.5, question number 1. Draw a rough sketch of the quadrilateral PQRS. Draw a rough sketch of quadrilateral PQRS. Quadrilateral means quadrilateral. Lateral means line, quadri means four. Means a closed geometric figure having four sides. It should have four sides, see, I have made four sides, 1, 2, 3, 4. You have to draw a rough sketch of quadrilateral PQRS, draw its diagonals, name them. Draw its diagonal and name them. Is the meeting point of the diagonal in the interior or exterior of the quadrilateral? Is the meeting point of the diagonals in the exterior or interior of the quadrilateral? First of all, we will draw E. Any quadrilateral you can draw. You can draw a square also. You can draw a rectangle also. So P, Q, R, S. Now diagonals are the lines which joins the opposite sides like this and the opposite vertices. So these are diagonals. The first question is, draw its diagonals and name them. So what will be the name of the diagonals? Name of diagonals are SQ and PR. Now the point, this point at which the diagonals meet is in the exterior or interior. So we'll write the point of intersection of two diagonals is in the interior . Next question. Again, to draw a quadrilateral KLMN, you have to draw another quadrilateral KLMN . Question number 2, draw a quadrilateral KLMN and state means give statement, A, two pairs of opposite sides. First of all, we'll draw it. K, L, M, N. It's a quadrilateral. First question is two pairs of opposite sides. Then its answer will be KM, LM, NM and KL. So line segment KM and LM and KL and NM. KL and NM. Next is two pair of opposite angles. B, two pairs of opposite angles. Okay, so these and these are opposite angles, angle K and angle M, one pair. Second pair is angle N and angle L, angle N and angle L. Next question is two pair of adjacent sides. Two pair of adjacent sides. Adjacent sides are the sides which has a common point. Two pairs of adjacent sides. KL, KN, KL and KN. One pair, second pair will be L, M, ML and MN. M, L and MN. Next is two pair of adjacent angles. Two pair of adjacent angles. Question number D. Two pair of adjacent angles. Adjacent angles would be this and these are adjacent angles, angle K and angle L, and one pair and second pair will be angle N and angle M. So these are adjacent. Purpose of doing this exercise is that you will be able to understand the meaning of opposite sides, adjacent sides, opposite angles, adjacent angles. Because these words will be now coming in word problems. In practical geometry, there is a chapter in your book itself, practical geometry, word problems will come in which these vocabularies will be used. So you have to learn these vocabularies and that practice is going on. Let us do the next question. Question number 4.5, exercise 4.5, question number 3. Use stripes and fasteners to make triangles and quadrilaterals. Try to push inward at any one vertex of the triangle. Do the same for the quadrilateral. Is the triangle distorted? Is it a quadrilateral? Why is the structure like electric towers? Make use of triangular shapes and not quadrilateral. Okay. So this is an investigatory question. Question is investigate. Alright, very nice question. So let us write down the points in the question. Use strips and fasteners to make triangle and quadrilateral. Use strips and fasteners. Means thread, we can take thread in this case, and we can take pins on board or on cardboard. To make triangle and quadrilateral. So we will take three pins . These are pins I have taken. Now this is a thread which is wound across it. These are pins and these are thread. For quadrilateral I will require 4 points. So 4 pins I will take out. These are the pins and then I will wind a thread like this. Now they are asking, try to push inward any one of the vertex of the triangle. Now if you will try to push this inward, you will find that it will be little difficult. But if you try to put this inward, it will be little easier. It can flip, no? This can flip. This side can flip. And it can form like this. So it can form a flip side. But what will happen if you try to pull this, then this force which you will apply will get distributed on the two sides. As a result, it will be difficult to put this point inward, but it will be easier to flip this point inward. Okay. Like if it is point A, this is flip point A. Flipped. A. So it is easy to flip this point A inside, but it is difficult to flip this point A, B, C, B, C. It is difficult to flip this point inward because the force gets distributed equally on the two points. But here the force does not get distributed evenly because it has got 3 points. Alright. Although it will resist a little bit, but not resist as good as it will resist. Now the question is, why is that the structures like electric towers make use of triangle shapes and not quadrilateral? Okay. How are electric towers made? Electric towers you will see are made like this. You will find that in the electric towers there are many triangles. Now these electric towers, they are connected with high tension wire. These are called as high tension wire. cables. These high tension wires and cables tries to pull the tower towards the other side. Alright. So if it is a triangular shaped, if this tower is triangular shaped, then it will not move easily. But if it will be quadrilateral shaped, then it will move very easily. So electric towers are never made like this. Electric towers are not made like this. If electric towers will be made like this, then due to high tension or due to the pull of the wires, the both side can get pulled. But in case of triangular towers, due to the high tension wire, the cable will not be able to pull the whole electric tower's structure to the other side. Okay, because this tension remains, and during storm more tension arises. When storms are there, then these wires they experience more force on it. So as a result, there are chances that these towers can get uprooted. So in case of a triangular shape, it resists the force caused on it due to the high tension wire. But in case of a quadrilateral shaped structure, there are chances that it can slide very easily. Alright, because here what happens, the whole load gets shifted uniformly both sides. But here what happens, the load directly falls on only the two ends and it can be pulled easily. Now the same thing, they are trying to give you an experience. They are asking you to make stripes. They are asking you to make stripes and they are asking you to pull one side. So if you will pull this side, you will find that the whole triangle will move. But here you will find that the structure will flip. So this structure is weaker, but this structure is stronger. Okay. Moreover, you can understand in this way also that one quadrilateral is actually made up of two triangles. It is made up of two triangles. Now, when there will be a force from this side, then this triangle can flip. But in case of only a triangle, only one triangle, where will it flip? It does not have that scope. So as a result, the whole structure can move if excess of force will be there on any of the vertices. And that is why the question arises, why is that the structure of electric towers make use of triangular shapes and not quadrilateral? So triangle is more rigid, you know. Triangles are more rigid. Quadrilaterals are less rigid. Rigid means ability to be in one place, not to move. Okay. Ability to withstand external force and not change its structure is called as rigidity. So shortly, I am looking forward to have a projector so that I can show you the pictures which I am drawing over here. So that picture will become even more easier for you to understand. As of now, you can imagine the picture of the pillars of bridges and the towers, or even Eiffel Tower if you have seen, it is triangular. So any tower if you make, or any monument if you will make, you will find that the base will be bigger and at the top it will become narrower, so that the weight that gets distributed at the base equally. And the base should be stronger enough to withstand the weight of the whole body on it. So that is the reason that we need to study geometry, because it will help you in future to become good engineers and architects even. So we'll do exercise 4.6 now.